Willow Spring Farm. We're doing some wine tasting tonight with a couple friends. Gonna have a good time. What a cute place to have a wedding, maybe. Beautiful in here. It smells like old barn, a wood place. Cute little sitting area right here. There's the restroom right there. Another restroom over here. Tastings. That's what we're doing today. This is the patio outside. It's a beautiful view. We saw the fireplace. And this is the vineyard. Well, this is some of the vineyard. And these wines. A lot of these wines are grown from these grapes from this vineyard. It's a beautiful area.
I was kind of looking around. I wasn't sure.
Yeah, no, we have a TV.
Big TV
but we
and I had
okay.
Is everyone here?
Yeah, we're all here.
All right. Everyone's over 21?
Yes.
So we do five tastings for $5, and you do get to take the glass home with you. There's some tasting cards here. I'm just gonna. Welcome, thanks for coming. This is a dump bucket. If there's anything you don't like, you can dump it out or pass it to the person on your left, either way. So we're going to start off with Vidal Blanc. This is a dry white wine. This one is 2016.
That one.
I can't pour. This one is very dry, clean and crisp.
What's the indulgence one?
It's a chocolate wine, so it's a red wine, Leon Malo, infused with chocolate.
That sounds good.
Yes.
Do you want a coffee?
Do you want a coffee?
Oh, yeah, I'll bring
it. Okay. But thank you.
Grassy.
Sweeter than the last one, so you're going to want to judge this one on the second sip. The first sip is going to seem really sweet in comparison to the last one. This one is 100% estate grown, so it goes from grape to bottle right here on site.
Should we aim to rinse our glasses or get new glasses?
It's white to white, and it's a sweeter wine, so you don't need to rinse your glasses if you do this water right there.
No, if I knew what I was doing, I'd be rinsing around in the mouth and spitting it out.
You're doing it in order, right?
No. In this order, no. Not really. It is
now
the next one down.
Now you just screw the whole process up of eliminating the lots of ones which.
This one? So this is this Vignole?
The Vignole, yeah.
And the one on top is the first one that we tried?
First one, yeah.
Oh, it smells nice and sweet.
Off dry rosé. It is a blend of red and white. So this is a blend of the Vignole that you just had, Marshall Coach, which is one of our reds, and Leon Malo, which is another red that we go here. This one is a 2015 varietal, so a little bit older. Typically you want red wines, you want them a little bit older, white wines, you want them a little bit younger. We get a mess all over the place. Seven, there's one more, right?
It's over there. I think it's Matt's.
Oh, really?
I'll just take that now.
What's happening is when it's stored in a cool wine cellar, is they're called wine diamonds.
This one you look for, Emerson, that one right there. So I think, yeah, that's Cedar Park.
All right. So the next one we have is called Cabernet Franc. You may have heard of Cabernet Sauvignon. You may have heard of Cabernet Franc. Cabernet Sauvignon is a bit more popular. Cabernet Franc is the parent of Cabernet Sauvignon, so the actual plant was blended with Cabernet Franc and Sauvignon Blanc. This one is a bit hardier, so we can grow it in this climate. This one is a 2014 varietal.
She
was on oak for 14 months.
Is that the garage with the house?
That's the
garage.
Yeah.
The Tuscan.
I think it's a lot.
The tough thing with Maine is it's hard to get a good house. It's not like terribly overpriced. But there are some people that think they're overpriced.
So this one has a heavy oak taste to it. Typically, our red wines tend to be a little bit more mild, a little bit more light on the tongue. With the oak in this one, it definitely makes it more sweet.
Yeah, there was one I know coming out that was like
an extra. Like. I gave it to Steven. Oh, then you take that and click that. So, the last one that we have is called Indulgence. This is a chocolate one. It's Leon Malo, one of the grapes that we make, infused with chocolate. This one is 2015. It's a mix. I think of it as a mix between like a port and a ice wine. It's a little heavier, okay, like a port, but it is.
Okay. It should be better.
Heavy like a port, not as heavy as a port, but it's sweeter like an ice wine. So it's kind of like.
I'm very excited for this.
I am excited now too that I heard about the ice wine.
This is a Willow Spring original, so there's really nothing to.
How much more is the wine coming with the house? Yeah.
This one's more of a. It's a sweeter dessert wine, so it's really not like something you would have a full glass of. Maybe you would.
Just try us.
It's definitely
that's what
more
you
of
think.
I thought that's what you were building up to.
It seems to be all that much in my glasses.
Yeah, this one we do less than a full ounce just because it's. And it does finish with chocolate.
Chocolate wine. It's kind of made with yeah. It's made with a chocolate, but it's blended with like an ice.
Wow. Why? Ladies, cheers. Cheers, yes.
No one would
get
a
cheer.
We got it.
You said you're ruining the
town. I was comfortable because I knew she was the one
that had you met. Thank you.
Woo! I'm going to tell you. You guys know you're drunk.
Your eyeball. Hey.
He's so happy.
I like fire.
Oh, that guy was
I'm getting here. Watching you come my way.
That's it.
The wine tasting at Willow Springs Vineyard went fantastically. This is the first time that some of my friends had ended up doing a wine tasting. It was not my first time, but it was my first time with these friends. And at this vineyard, which I have some information for, and I will say it in a few minutes. Sorry about my voice. I currently have a cold. I guess hanging out with all of my friends got me sick. So the wine tasting was a 5 for 5, which is 5 wines for $5. I'm not exactly sure if that is what it is all of the time, or if that was just a special. It was also the very first day that it was open for the season. So the wines that we tasted, and this is the order that we tasted them in. It's not the order on the list, but it was the Videl Blanc. That was the first white. The second white was the Vignolles. I'm so sorry if I'm butchering these. The third one was the Rosé, which was called Pink. The fourth was the Cabernet Franc, which is a red. And most of us are not red drinkers to begin with, and as you saw in the video, I was not a fan of that as well. That was the only one that we actually dumped out. The last one was the Indulgence, and that was the chocolate wine, and that was excellent. It's a dessert wine. You're only supposed to really have small portions of it, but as you also noticed, my husband actually poured his into my cup. out of all of those, my favorite was actually the pink. It was the rosé. I love rosés, but I wasn't sure if I was going to like that one, as she explained that it's mixed. I mean, as I'm assuming all rosés are, but it was actually mixed with the red that I wasn't a fan of, so I was actually very surprised that I did like that one. But all in all, it was a fantastic time. And then afterwards, we went to Time Hibachi in, I believe it is North Andover in that spot. So the Willow Springs Vineyard is in Haverhill. And then the Hibachi place was in North Andover. That was a fun time. We got there and we had a large party, so we had to wait a little while. But when we did finally get, we got our own little party room before we got sat, so that was nice to be able to sit and just talk, so that we had we didn't have to stand around the bar. And then dinner was excellent. Hibachi's always fun. It's a dinner and a show. But here is some information on the Willow Springs Vineyards. Like I said, it's located in Haverhill, Mass. And as they estate grown and hand harvested, they are open. They are now open for the season. They are open Wednesdays 9 a.m. to 2 p.m., Thursdays and Fridays from 2 p.m. to 8 p.m., and Sundays from 12 p.m. to 6 p.m. They are also open on Saturday nights, and they are open for live music, and I believe that starts at 7 p.m. every Saturday. Once again, that'll also be on their website for you to find out who's playing and what time they're playing. And they do wine tastings, and you can also buy off their menu during the live band. The wines that we had tasted are the wines that are currently available for tastings. With every season, the wines will change, so if you look on their website, it will let you know ahead of time what wines are available for that night. If you wanted to find out any more information about Willow Springs Vineyards, they have a Facebook, Willow Spring Vineyards. They have an Instagram, Willow Springs Vin, V-I-N. They have a Twitter, Willow Spring Vin, V-I-N. And willowspringvineyards.com is their website. So if you wanted to find any more information, you could find it there. I hope you guys enjoyed my review and our time with the vineyard and the Hibachi. That's little James. This has been Mommy Saurus Rex. Thanks. Bye.